Ladies and gentlemen, higher education is no longer a luxury, but it is essential to national, social, and economic development. Reforms in this sector have become vital in the context of globalization and knowledge economy. Consequently, the role of the universities is central to the creation of knowledge, scientific and technological development, and innovation, in addition to the production and graduation of quality students. This has been very well recognized by bringing a major shift in the functions of the universities, that is to excel in teaching, focus on research and community services. In this context, curriculum is revised and updated to incorporate the concept of outcome-based education, assessment parameters, continuous quality improvements, new scientific developments, and professional ethics to harmonize different parameters for the recognition and mobility of graduates and engineers. This has established the need for participation in international accords and agreements, such as Bologna, Washington, Sydney, and Dublin accords for international recognition, equivalence, and global mobility of graduates. In Pakistan, in recent years, exponential growth has occurred in higher education, both in public and private sectors. 60 universities out of 135 are offering engineering programs in 23 engineering disciplines. A campaign has been launched to enhance quality and to define the program learning outcomes and revision of curricula. Emphasis is placed on innovation, entrepreneurship, relevance of current research to the societal needs. This can help to meet the challenges and solve problems in the fields of education, manufacturing, energy, food, water, security, climate change, and economic growth. GIK Institute has endeavored to undertake the role of a modern university. It strives to contribute in the rapid advancement of technology and industrial transformation of the country by producing professionals of high caliber. Promoting engineering education in the country as an icon of quality, the Institute has produced 35 PhDs, 210 MS, and over 2,600 BS graduates in the field of engineering, who are now serving in various national and multinational organizations. In this convocation, PhD degrees will be awarded to 7 students, along with 21 MS and 248 BS students. It is important to mention that the GIK Institute is in the lead in producing highest number of indigenous PhD graduates amongst all engineering universities of the country. The quest for knowledge and understanding of science has led to many new developments. The emerging fields of computational science, information technology, biotechnology, neuroscience, and nanotechnology, which deals with the manipulation of bits, bytes, genes, cells, neurons, atoms, and molecules, are considered to be the building blocks for 21st century new devices, appliances, structures, and materials. They are expected not only to cure cancer and genetic disorder and increase the life expectancy, but change the world around us in coming years. The convergence of nanotechnology with the growing potential of computer, information and communication technology with the orders of magnitude smaller and faster will be the engine driving technological innovation in near future. The ability to control matter at the atomic scale and build devices with atomic precision is central to nanotechnology. The application of nanomaterials, nanodevices, nanostructures are now considered in the field of construction, engineering, transport, energy, sensors, micro and nanoelectronics, security, environment, pharmaceutical, biomedical, and aerospace industry. The importance of this technology can be realized by the fact that 3 Nobel Prizes are awarded for research related to C60, carbon nanotubes, and graphene structures. An example of commercialization of scientific discovery made in the 80s is now utilized to produce USB data storage device that work on the principle of GMR, that is giant magnetoresistance, which has won the Nobel Prize in 2007. In this area, new graphene nano ribbon devices are designed and fabricated with very large value of magnetoresistance owing to unique electronic and metallic properties of graphene structure. Ladies and gentlemen, the landscape of higher education is changing fast, and we have to keep pace with these changes to determine relevance, quality, and internationalization. The GIK Institute is striving to act as an effective agent of change and to become a symbol of quality education in engineering by bringing a new tradition of research and to meet the international standards and quality benchmarks. In the last 8 years, the Institute has produced 650 research papers which were published in the International Journal of Reputes and refereed conference proceedings. As part of the International Linkages Program, the Institute is participating as an active partner with other international collaborators in research projects. These projects have enabled us to establish research labs and facilities to participate in joint research projects with industry and R&D institutions. 15 research projects are underway that are sponsored by Higher Education Commission, National ICT Fund, and Pakistan Science Foundation. Recently, another project is approved by the Directorate of Science and Technology, Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, to establish a high-performance computing facility for research in the area of computational science, modeling, and simulation. As part of the industry-academia linkages program, we are providing consultancy and testing services to the industry and collaborating on design and research projects. This year, 2 technical reports were accomplished for industry. 3 short courses were organized for the participants of local industry and graduate students. The topics covered are engineering management, total energy management, and power plant efficiency. 2 courses, one on frontiers of computational science, and the second jointly with WABDA on engineering fundamentals for non-engineers are planned in the next 2 months. We are thankful to SOPRES for their approval of the new initiatives and scholarships for undergraduate and graduate students. Ladies and gentlemen, in this academic year, we completed the admission cycle with the selection of 479 students on merit out of 5,400 applicants who applied for admission. Apart from 230 courses offered at graduate and undergraduate level, 31 student events, conferences, competitions were organized by societies and chapters for professional development and co-curricular activities. The curricula of computer, material, and engineering science programs are revised to include new streams of nanotechnology and minor in management with major in engineering programs. New programs of engineering management, energy system engineering at master level, and chemical engineering and electrical engineering with specialization in power at BS level are introduced. Self-assessment reports of 6 BS degree programs are prepared to collect information and feedback from employers, alumni, faculty, and graduating students. This has helped us to take measures for improvement and revision of policy. The role of GIK is recognized by the fact that the Institute has been ranked 3rd in the HEC ranking carried out this year. And previously in 2006, in the category of engineering and technology. The ranking based on parameters related to quality assurance, teaching quality, and research output. The recently concluded industrial open house and career fair, which is one of the most important events in the Institute calendar, has brought together over 100 representatives and professionals from industry and research organizations to interact with the faculty and students. 82 projects were displayed by the final year and research students that highlighted the ongoing research activities in the Institute. This forum has produced a much closer interaction between academia and industry for collaboration in productivity, research, and innovation. It is gratifying to note that our graduates are hired by industry, R&D institutions, and multinational companies. This year, the response has been much better as compared to last year's. I believe that the participation of research students in these activities has led to better recognition of their research by the industry and to help the institute in the establishment of incubation center and startup companies in order to achieve their commercial benefits. As part of the professional activities, this summer over 300 students will join industrial and software houses for internship program in the country and abroad. Three teams will participate in international competitions in Malaysia and India. These competitions challenge students worldwide to design, build, and test fuel-efficient vehicles using as little energy as possible. Five students have gone abroad for 6 months international research program funded by the Higher Education Commission. 11 faculty members and research students attended international conferences to present their research papers. Honorable Chief Guest, the faculty is committed to achieve excellence in engineering and research in order to realize the aspirations of the founding fathers. We are prepared to take the role of a modern university to create and disseminate knowledge and facilitate translation of knowledge into patents, products, and softwares to create business opportunity and to serve the community at large. In order to achieve the goals of holistic education, the students are encouraged to organize and participate in professional and co-curricular activities. The conducive environment at campus provides an opportunity to develop managerial skills and leadership qualities in addition to their formal academic program. We recognize that the faculty and graduates are critical resources that can make a valuable contribution to the economic development of the country. In order to meet the short-term objectives, we have to adopt a plan for upgradation of infrastructure to enhance academic facilities and strengthen research and graduate program. We realize that in order to remain competitive and to meet the new challenges, we got to consider options for fundraising, increase number of scholarships and financial assistance to strengthen industrial and international linkages. Ladies and gentlemen, we have among us a large number of parents. For them, this day brings a sense of satisfaction, joy, and pride. I offer my heartiest congratulations to the proud parents. To the graduating students, I offer my warmest congratulations and wish them all the best in future. You have worked hard to achieve this milestone. The degree that you get today is not your final destination. Let it be just a starting point to embark upon your journey to excellence. Make acquisition of knowledge a lifelong passion. Only then you can reach the pinnacle of glory as professionals. Use your capabilities for the betterment of your profession, your family, your nation, and the entire mankind. I sincerely hope that you will always keep the Jeeky flag high. I'm sure that the knowledge and learning experience you had at the campus will be a great help to meet the new challenges of the world. Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah, while addressing Student Federation, said, "You must concentrate on gaining knowledge and education. It is your foremost responsibility. Political awareness of the era is also part of your education. You must be aware of international events and environment. Education is a matter of life and death for our country." Ladies and gentlemen, whatever we have achieved is due to untiring efforts of our faculty. I appreciate the services rendered by the faculty and thank them for their commitment and devotion. I also thank the administration and staff for their remarkable contribution in our success. I would also like to express my gratitude to President Soprest, Executive Director, and members of the Executive Committee for their full support. Honorable Chief Guest, valued parents, ladies and gentlemen, I'm grateful to you for being with us. Your presence has given grace and dignity to this convocation. I once again thank you so much.
The rector of the Ghulam Ishaq Khan Institute, Engineer Mr. Jahangir Bashir, is now invited to address the convocation.
Barrister Masood Kausar, Governor Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, Engineer Shamsul Mulk, President Soprest and our Board of Governors, members of the Board of Governors and the Executive Committee, Dr. Shaukat Ameed Khan, Executive Director, Pro-Rector, Deans, Faculty Members, Excellencies, guests, parents, and the day belongs to the graduating students. You will have, I think I mentioned this last year, sir, that there is always a tussle between husband and wife, since we can accommodate one family member in this hall. And like last year, you can see that the ladies have won. It is a matter of great honor and pleasure for me to extend a most cordial welcome on behalf of all my colleagues to all the distinguished ladies and gentlemen who accepted our invitation to be our guests at the 16th convocation of the Ghulam-e-Issaq Khan Institute of Engineering, Sciences and Technology. We thank you all for being with us. We are especially grateful to the Honorable Chief Guest, Barrister Masood Kausar, Governor Khyber Pakhtunkhwa, for finding the time to visit the Institute and preside over this convocation. Sir, your presence has added greatly to the dignity of this occasion. The Institute owes you a debt of gratitude, sir. On your last visit, you promised to double the number of scholarships awarded to our students by the government of Khyber Pakhtunkhwa. All of us were very pleasantly surprised when soon the provincial government informed us that in deference to the wishes of the governor, the number of scholarships had been raised from 10 to 20 each year. And I would like to thank you for keeping another promise you made last year by granting 10 scholarships for students from FATA. May I add that GIK itself dedicates 10% of its own revenue to scholarships and financial assistance to those in need. No account of the inspiring saga of this institute would be complete without mentioning the name of Mr. Ghulam-e-Issaq Khan, the former president of the Islamic Republic of Pakistan and his associates. Inspired by the passion to serve the nation, they conceived the institute as a center of excellence in engineering education. Taking rapid strides from its very inception within a very short time, the GIK Institute won recognition from the highest academic circles, both nationally and internationally. And I should tell you, sir, that a few weeks ago, I met Sayed Babar Ali of LUMS and HSN College fame, and he said to me, "You have this gem in the north." Please take care of it. Both you and the KPK government should take care of it. I must also express our appreciation and gratitude to Engineer Shamsul Mulk, the President Soprest, and all the members of the GIK Board and Executive Committee for their continued support and guidance. We have many other friends whose support has been invaluable. Prominent among these are the Higher Education Commission, the provincial governments, particularly that of KPK, the National ICT Program, Pakistan Science Foundation, and our alumni. I would like to recognize here the establishment of a scholarship fund in the name of his family by Mr. Yusuf Shirazi. A member of our board, we are most grateful to you, sir. There is also the Professor Mia Zahinuddin Memorial Scholarship by his son, Mia Irshad Zahin. The Ayub Memorial Scholarship in honor of his father by Dr. Zahid Ayub. The GIK Alumni Association members also provide scholarships to a substantial number of students, And there are others, companies, individuals, trusts. I thank you all. In the contemporary world, the corpus of knowledge is expanding at a mind-boggling pace. Many new ideas and concepts are emerging and must be adopted, and sometimes adopted after being adapted. This requires constant review of the curricula and courses of studies and research to make them compatible with international standards. We in this institute believe that the process of education must also impact the total personality of the learner in all its many aspects: physical, intellectual, social, cultural, moral, and professional. To achieve this objective, we offer our students a wide variety of academic courses in our several faculties and an array of co-curricular activities like debates, essay writing, drama, art, and other social and sports events. There are, as you probably heard earlier, there are some 25 student societies, including GIK chapters of a number of national and international academic and technical organizations. All these are run by the students themselves under the guidance of faculty advisors. This has paid us rich dividends, as our alumni carry the distinct GIK stamp, which is highly valued by institutions of higher studies in different parts of the world and in the national and international job markets. For this, I commend the dedication of our world-class faculty, particularly the pro-rector academic and the deans. And I mustn't forget the heads of all the support arms of the Institute and their colleagues, from sanitary workers to security guards to plumbers and electricians to directors and deputy directors, for keeping the GIK engine well oiled and running. A word about our future plans. You've heard some of it. The Institute started in January this year two postgraduate degree programs in engineering management and energy systems engineering. From August this year, two new undergrad programs in chemical and power engineering will also commence. I wish to tell you, sir, that the interest in these programs from among the large number of applicants up till now, we're in that process of admissions right now, sir.